the students didn't do well. You got it? So this is what we call compound
sentences.
Compound
sentences.
Compound sentence. In a compound sentence, you combine or join
between two sentences.
Two clauses. Two clauses. In a clause, we have a subject
and
a verb. Yes, and both of them, in both parts, we have independent clauses. In a compound sentence, we have independent clauses.
Or contain simple
sentences. Or contains, yeah, two simple sentences.
Yes.
Because this simple sentence can also constitute two MPs. I can say, I can use this one. The teacher and the students come to the class. The class was closed. Yes? So this part is a simple sentence, and the other part is also another simple sentence, and you combine them. Is it clear? So this is a compound sentence, is a sentence in which you join two simple sentences. Complex sentence?
Complex, more than sentence.
No, it's a sentence in which you combine one dependent and one independent clause. In this example, we are joining two
independent
clauses. So this is why we call it a compound sentence. But in a complex sentence, we are combining two. One of them is independent and the other one is dependent. So this is why changing these subjects into nouns is a better term. Now, how to make your sentences longer? One of the easiest ways to write a longer sentence is to take two good basic sentences and combine them. And that's what we did here. How to join these two? How to combine these two? Example?
Sam sees the tree while Willie hears the birds.
Okay. Here? Sam sees the tree. Willie hears the birds.
Yes.
How can you join them together?
Why Sam sees the tree?
Don't use why, because now we want a compound sentence and not a complex sentence.
Sam
sees the tree
and why
Willie hears the
birds.
Or a semicolon. I mean, there are different ways to combine them. We will come to know how to join these two simple sentences. Here, sentences can be combined with punctuations like semicolon. This is one way. Example: Sam sees the tree. Willie hears
the
birds. This is one way. Then, coordinators, known as conjunctions also. You have Sam sees the tree, comma, and Willie hears the
birds.
See, because and is a coordinator, we use comma before it. Mm-hmm. Coordinator means it joins two simple sentences.
Mm-hmm.
So after the first sentence, you add the comma,
and
space, and then and. Don't forget this, comma, space, and. But if and is used between the two subjects, I mean the two MPs in the subject, do I add the comma?
Mm-hmm.
No. If and is,
yes.
If and is introduced between two verbs, like she writes and and cooks. So she writes and cooks here, and do I add comma before it?
No.
Yes, you add it between when you coordinate two clauses, two simple sentences. Coordinators are another easy way to combine two short sentences into a longer one. So these are the
coordinators
used to combine sentences. We can abbreviate them in the word. Which word I give you in the last previous lesson?
Funny.
Fan boys. Yes,
boys.
We have it here. Fan.
Fan boys.
Fan boys. F for.
And.
Fa.
For.
For.
And.
And.
Nor.
Nor.
But.
But.
Or.
Or.
Yet.
Yet.
So.
So.
Fan boys.
Sam sees and hears the birds, but Willie
sleeps.
Yeah. Now we use also to join sentences, but to form complex sentences, we use subordinators, another kind of conjunctions, and they are abbreviated in the word wish about. Yes, wish about. Here are the words: who, what, where, when, why, which, whether, why. If, since, so that have these words, I mean these subordinators. Why do we call them subordinators? Who can guess the meaning? Check, okay? Why do we call them subordinators? This is your assignment. The fragment. Now, what is a fragment? By now we know what's a sentence, yes? A sentence must have a subject and a verb and a complete meaning, or it has to be an independent clause. And then we said that we can join two clauses or two dependent clauses using coordinators. And we say also that we can join two one independent and dependent clauses using subordinators. Now, what's the fragment? Here. After having learned to recognize a complete sentence, you should be able to identify a fragment, which is only a part of a sentence. So a fragment is a part of a sentence, it's not a complete sentence. So it's smaller than a sentence. And some students feel that they have written a sentence, but what they presented is less than a sentence. Some elements are missing.
Like a phrase.
Yeah, phrases, yes. Incomplete, like independent clauses, for example, and not fall into the trap of punctuating a fragment as though it were a sentence. Here are the six types of fragments that are likely to cause problems and the ways to correct them. One, a dependent clause. A dependent clause is not a sentence. Can I add a full stop after although?
No.
As a clause starting with although, can I add a full stop there? No, because it needs an independent clause to make it complete. The problem, after the farmer cleared his field, okay, so how to correct this problem? Because this is not a complete sentence. This is an independent, a dependent clause. Solution, add an independent
clause
to make it complete. So, after the farmer cleared his field, he planted the corn. So here, after the farmer cleared his field, comma. Yes, this is the independent, he planted. Two, a prepositional phrase. What's a prepositional phrase? Prepositional phrase? Yes? What? No, I told you it's a prepositional phrase. Okay, how many phrases do we have in English, in general? We have a noun phrase, a verb phrase, adjective phrase, adverbial phrase, and a prepositional phrase. Mm-hmm. So, an adjective phrase, the head is adjective.
Adjective.
Huh? Yes.
This is our time.
Excuse me? A good phrase?
Lucia, this is our time.
I'm not talking about the meaning. I'm talking about the structure, form. So here, adjective phrase. Head is adjective, like hardworking or intelligent. Yes?
Yes.
Here I can add very.
Mm-hmm.
Yes? This is a modifier. But the head word is intelligent. So this is an adjective phrase. And this is the head word. Adverb phrase? Fast. He writes fast. I can say he writes very fast. Quiet, fast. Any word before it. So this is the head. The head is the adverb. Adverb phrase? See, I don't want to confuse you. Let's go into the prepositional phrase. In a prepositional phrase, it is introduced with a preposition. In the class.
At.
At?
At the morning. At 6 o'clock.
At 6 o'clock. Okay. And so on.
On the
morning. Huh?
Yes.
On the table and so on. So through the woods. Yes?
Okay.
So these are prepositions. These are the head. This is the head word. And because it is introduced with a preposition, this is called the prepositional phrase. Preposition and a noun phrase. Preposition and the noun phrase. Okay? So some students think that a prepositional phrase is a sentence, but this is not
a sentence.
It's not a sentence, it's a fragment. And you need to add something to make it a complete
sentence.
Example, throughout his report. Solution? Add an independent
clause.
There were numerous errors throughout his report. So there were numerous errors. This is an independent clause. A verbal phrase. This is also a fragment. Typing the letter for the saleswoman. Change the verb into a verb. Is this a verb?
No.
This is a
adverb.
Why? Who can tell me the reason?
Because ing.
Huh? Because ing. Okay. So what? You don't have verbs in ing forms.
And.
Comes.
Huh?
In the beginning.
Subjective.
Yeah, but I can use it in
without
the subject position. Typing the letter for the saleswoman is my duty. This is a correct sentence in English.
What?
Typing the letter for the saleswoman is my duty. This is a correct sentence in English.
Yes.
Okay? But this is a verb. This is called the gerund. Esma furud. This is a verb. And not a verb. Why? How can I change it into a verb? How can I make this typing a verb? When can I add the ing form to the verb? What is the structure? What is the form of ing of continuous? Yes.
I'm typing.
You have the verb, the auxiliary verb. Be. Either am, was, or is. Where or at? Yes, we have those auxiliaries before the verb. Do you have these auxiliaries here?
No.
No. So this is not the ing form of the verb. This is the gerund form, typing. بمعنى طباعة. Yes. It's not يطبع. It's not to write. Yes, it is طباعة. Yeah. So typing the letter for the saleswoman here, this is not a verb, it's a verbal phrase. And you have to change it into a verb. This is one of the ways you can solve this problem. So how to change it, into a verb? This is one way. Jane, you add the subject and the auxiliary. Jane was typing the letter for the saleswoman. This is one thing. Another way, add an independent clause and the sentence will be typing the letter for the saleswoman, comma, Jane was quick and efficient. Or you can say, is my duty. Is my duty. Do you know the meaning of duty? Huh? Okay. So you can say, typing the letter for the saleswoman is my duty. It will be a subject. You can consider it as a subject phrase. Typing the letter for the saleswoman. And then you add a verb and its complement. Is my duty. Or you can add an independent clause here. So, typing the letter for the salesman, comma, Jane, this is an independent
clause.
Jane was quick and efficient. So you have these ways. See, how to understand the solution, you have to understand the sentence. To understand the appropriate or to be able to select a solution depends on your understanding of the sentence. If you can understand the sentence, then only you can correct it, yes. You can find a solution to the problem. A subject. Sometimes you might have a subject and you will mistake it for a complete sentence, but this is not right also. Problem, example here, the engineers at the chemical
plant.
The engineers at the chemical plant. What? This is a subject.
Because not complete sentence.
Yeah, this is not a complete. Yeah, but some students will think that this is a sentence. What is the head of this phrase?
The engineer.
The engineer.
Engineers, yes?
Engineers.
And then at the chemical plant, these are modifiers.
Okay.
This is a subject. How can I make it a complete sentence?
Add the verb.
Add a verb and its complement. Here, add a verb. The engineers at the technical or at the chemical plant were on strike. Or the engineers were at the chemical
plant.
It's up to you. It depends on your information, on what you want to convey. Sometimes you will have a verb and you will mistake it for a false sentence. Took his temperature. Who took his temperature? What is the subject here? So you add a subject. The nurse took his temperature. Other phrases, because we said something about prepositional phrase, verbal phrases, this thing, subject. So now we have other phrases, such as memos and reports. This is a noun phrase, such as memos and reports. Yes. Add an independent
clause,
because this is a dependent one. It needs something to complete it. The assistant type business correspondence, such as memos and reports. Now, run-on sentences. What's the problem with run-on sentences? When you write too much without any punctuation. It's just the opposite of fragments. In a fragment, you write less. In a run-on sentence, you write too much that the reader won't be able to understand where you started and where you stopped. And the connection between these parts of the sentence or of the your expression. Run-on sentences are two more two more.